Hello, Jeff and Joelle. Do you guys think there are certain dog breeds first-time dog owners shouldn't get?
Yes.
Just curious to know your opinion.
Absolutely. A Malinois.
Dutch Shepherd.
Dutch Shepherd, Malinois, possibly even a German Shepherd, unless it's a really laid-back dog. I would probably...
Border Collies,
cattle dogs. I'd be really careful about any of your higher drivey dogs, but I also don't know your skill set. And I don't know what your heart tells you. If you feel that the dog is going to be trained through love and affection, most dogs are going to not do well with you. So, but if you're open to all different training philosophies, which there's only technically reward and punishment, so that makes it really simple, then your life will be easier. But any of your higher drive dogs can be really challenging for first-time dog owners. Next. Going live. Now we're live. Hey, everybody, how are you doing? It's Jeff Gellman, Sally Canine Training, and Joelle, and this is the What Would Jeff Do show. Ooh, you know what I don't have up there? I took it down still from Angelo's thing. Stick that right up there. Is that the one we use? Or we use the other one? Oh, we'll put that one up there.
That's
this
not
week.
It, but we
that's
can
not it? That.
No, usually it's no border.
That yeah. One. There we go. Hey everybody, how is everybody doing? It's Jeff Gellman again of Sally Canine Training. This is the What Would Jeff Do show. That's why we put the little logo up there, What Would Jeff Do? And this is Joelle, how are you? And this is the thing. It's a 90-minute show. Most people ask, how do I stop unwanted behaviors? How do I stop this? How do I stop that? So we talk about punishment a lot. Remember, with punishment, to people that really, really important that they understand, punishment has got nothing to do with yelling, screaming, you're not upset, you're not mad. It's just matter of fact, you're trying to put an inhibitor into the dog, you can't do it. You can't do that. Also, we do something, and there's something called Top Chat, so we don't get through all the questions. Like on Monday, what day is today, Wednesday, Friday?
Wednesday,
we didn't get through all the questions at all. I really didn't even go on a rant. Well, we just like to chit-chat. Plus, it's a free freaking show. But you can do a top chat. Your question goes to the top of the queue, but you do not have to pay to play. But obviously, earlier you get your question in, the earlier that we answer it. But it's a free show, and that's just how it works. First come, first serve. We also do a seminar series called Jeff Gellman Seminars. Jeff Gellman Seminars, check that out. We'll be down in Florida. It's the only seminar that we're doing down in Florida. So you might want to go to that, so you can drive if you're within 300 miles. It's definitely going to be worth it.
What
happened? So you want me to stop you from picking your nails?
Yeah, but you like scratched.
Oh, I didn't mean
process.
To. I mean, I just meant to like do that move. So, and that again is also, that's a triage 2-day seminar, bringing the worst behaved dogs that you have. Human aggression, dog aggression, leash reactivity, it doesn't make a difference. If you can get your dog through the door, some people can barely get the dog through the door, your dog will leave better behaved. Happens all day long, every time. We're doing 28 seminars. We think this year we're trying to still shoot for the Phoenix area. We're doing 7 different countries. And then we've got the training center, which is where we're at now. It's a 17,000 square foot training center. And we've got an awesome staff of 4 trainers. And we work dogs all day long, technically 24 hours a day. You can tell they're all quiet right now. And here we go. Joelle asks the questions, I give the answers. Let's get right into it here, so hopefully we can get through all the questions.
Melissa, good evening, Jeff and Joelle and everyone in the chat.
Hey, everybody.
John, hey Jeff, hope all is well. How is your guy's day been?
Things are fantastic. I know we talked a little bit this morning about a bill that was being passed in Hawaii. It's like, okay, guys, we know the wording has been changed. They took e-collars out. So there's been a lot of stuff, people saying, oh no, you don't understand the tethering thing. Okay. I'm a huge advocate of not tethering on choke chains and prong collars as well. But it was presented as a ban e-collar bill. Shock collar bill. Ban shock collars in a font 10 times bigger than the font of the actual bill. That is what everybody was pushing for. The fine print says all the other stuff. That's the way they presented it. We know it's been taken out, but it was presented that way. Usually people don't read the fine print. Trust me, I know. They don't look past the headline ever. But you can't confine your animal to a crate. You can't restrain your animal. Restrain. Very, very, very wide interpretation there. Confine interpretation. A lot of very wide interpretations. People need to understand that they're trying to take away pet ownership. In fact, PETA just came out with a statement that says they don't even want you to call them pets anymore. I hope people understand that PETA does not want you to own an animal. Any domesticated animal. They're not an animal rights group. They're a hate group using animals as their Trojan horse. I hope people understand that. So these wide-ranging bills are there as Trojan horses under the guise of animal cruelty. I'm against animal cruelty as well. Then boost up your animal cruelty laws, but there's a big difference between your dog's leg being sawed off, videotaped for fun, sitting in battery acid, than putting your dog in a crate or on a tie-out or using a remote collar. Humongous difference. Or bonking. Big, big, big difference. So, but I'm telling you, if you're going to, it's going to happen within 5 years, and dog trainers have to stop being the ones that yell and scream. Dog owners need to start standing up and sharing your stories. So every dog owner out there who has had success through any type of correction at all needs to contact the people that make these laws saying, listen, stop taking away our rights to ban something. To use something. Stop taking away our rights to use the tools that we want. Just because you don't want to use a remote collar, that doesn't mean I shouldn't be able to do one. Next.
Deb, hello everyone. Thank God it's Friday.
Yes.
Oh yeah, it is Friday, huh? Life. Hello. I wanted to start losing my voice. I wanted to start feeding my dogs a raw diet. I can't talk right now. My gosh. How would you recommend doing the transition?
You can get the book. We've got the book, E-Collar, the Raw Food Guide. You can do the Raw Food Guide. Go buy that. Go onto our website, solidcaninetraining.com/shop. And start with that book, and you'll get a lot of great ideas. Next.
John, any chance for a confidence room video in the future?
Yes, we will.
Gretchen, hi, guys. We're all eagerly waiting to hear what Jeff has to say about Hawaii's e-collar ban. Love your hair, Joelle.
Set it. Put it up as soon as I found it. This is what's the funny part is. That legislation was proposed a year ago.
I know. Why is everyone just talking about it the day of?
Why did most people, I found out about it this morning. Mm-hmm. I think most people found out about it this morning. Why? Mm-hmm. Where's the lobbyists? Where's the big e-collar manufacturers? Where are the 4 to 5 big e-collar manufacturers? Where are they? Between the 5 of them? They should have lobbyists in Washington making sure these tools stay legal. And whatever you're feeling on a lobbyist is, remember, these are Trojan horses. It's an easy sell, take away a shock collar. That's an easy sell. But I'm telling you, they voted in Vancouver. You can't say no to your dog harshly. It didn't pass. In Sweden, you can't have a crate door on your crate. That's law. I'm telling you, there's a federal bill right now there's a federal bill up there right now for veterans struggling with PTSD for service dogs that they cannot be trained other than through positive reinforcement. Good luck. I wouldn't want a service dog that was not corrected for inappropriate behavior. Next.
Michelle, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, how are you?
Kibu. Hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Hello.
Kathy. Hi. 3 very high energy dogs, 2 border collies, 1 Dutch shepherd.
Yep.
I have a pretty good training skills. I want to be able to have all dogs in the backyard throw a ball for one whilst others are waiting their turn for me to throw theirs.
Fine.
But not sure how to start teaching that. Thanks for the help.
So what you do is make sure they've got really good downstays. Keep them on leashes. Hold 2 of them back. Say one dog's name. One dog's name, teach name recognition commands. So say name of dog, break, they go get the ball. Other name of dog, first of all, this, how about this? all three dogs in downstays, throw a ball, nobody moves. Start there. Then name recognition releases. Start there, but keeping them on leashes. Next.
Blessing. Any tips on how to get Dakota to stop? How to get Dakota to accept handling? Accept handling.
From who?
I don't know. Handling, like, from a vet? Like.
So, for handling, you would use a counter condition protocol. We use clicker and food for that. So, what you do is, say you want to touch the dog's back. So, what you do is you have the dog, just make sure you clicker condition the dog first, and use our dog's daily meals. So, use the dog's daily meals for the food. The dog eats 2 cups a day. Take 2 cups a day. Put it in a little pouch. That's what we're training with today. So, you're still feeding your dog its allotted food. You're not withholding the food, but you're using the food as the reward. Because if you use treats as a reward, for the amount of repetitions you've got to do, you're gonna end up with a fat dog.
Cheryl always says my volume's low. I don't know why. I'm just gonna move this closer to me.
Okay, that's fine.
I talk softer than you.
Yeah. All right.
I need my own mic.
All right. So yeah. So, what were we talking about?
Accept handling.
Accept handling. Okay. So what you do is. Lightly touch, click, food. Lightly touch, click, food. Lightly touch, click, food. Over and over and over again, all parts of the body. Next.
Apex EDC, what level do you recommend for first-time e-collar use? 9-month-old Malinois, food aggression. Also, how long of a hold?
So, what level? I don't know. So, number one, for food aggression, you make it suck. So, if you want to get it done really quick, you make it suck. So, a high level. What level that is? A level high enough that the dog comes off the food. The problem with the Malinois is my Malinois blows through 100 in drive. So you're going to have a leash on the dog for some guidance as well. Put the dog on a tie back. Next.
Faux Fish. Hi, J&J. Greetings from Austria.
Oh, hey, Austria. How are you?
Michelle, I heard the whole e-collar, etc. was pulled from the Hawaii bill for today. Loads of folks were calling, emailing, spamming social media for the voters. Well done, dog owners and trainers.
Yep. Dog owners need to stand up and scream. Yep, definitely. And we're going to leave our live up there. We can easily take it down, but we want to leave it up there because we want people to understand what's going on. What's going on out there? And there's a couple of comments out there that were like, "Oh no, if it's a well-written bill, it's about animal cruelty." It's like, "No, it's not about animal cruelty." They want you to think it's about animal cruelty, but it's not about animal cruelty. It's about taking away your rights. People are not seeing the big picture at all on any of this. I've been talking about this for a long time.
I remember hearing you talk about this like literally like 5 years ago on your podcast.
On my radio show, I talked about this, which was 10 years ago. I'm telling you, in less than 5 years, it's going to be so difficult to own a dog. And everyone now that has an easy dog, easy for you to say, or someone that has a dog that isn't well-trained, easy for you to say. But if you want a well-trained dog, well, if you spent more time training it, it's got nothing to do with time. Okay? It has nothing to do with time, spending more time and patience. And why? If there's an effective way of doing something, why? Why do you have to do time and patience? And it's funny because it's about animal cruelty. That's why they want to get rid of shock collars. Why haven't they banned cigarettes then? Why are cigarettes not illegal? But it's a health hazard. It says it right on the box. These cigarettes cause cancer. Why have they not made them illegal? It's an optional purchase. I mean, it becomes an addiction. You know? I don't want them to become illegal. Do you know why? I don't smoke. I don't care. Don't smoke near me. If you did, I don't want there. I won't go into an establishment that smells like smoke. I won't be around a smoker. That usually pisses off. I got a memo on that. Oh my God, you just pissed off half your audience. Well, hey, half my audience. I love you so much. I don't want you to die. Stop smoking.
True story.
Okay. Sorry. Statistically, it's not good. We know it's not good for you. Next.
No, just ask my mother how bad it is. She's going on 1 year of her recovery from her freaking terrible artery clogging bullshit. Cheryl, hi Jeff and Joelle, happy Friday.
Hey. Friday, by the way, we don't have Friday.
I know, like, what is Friday?
Friday, we don't look forward to Fridays, guys. So a little bit,
actually, Monday is my favorite day of the week.
So we don't look forward to Fridays. Sorry, I don't work for the weekend. Nope. Every day is a great day. Next.
Faux fish, any news on the UK seminar tickets? When will they be available?
UK seminar tickets will not be available for at least 2 more months till this all comes. But they're happening. Don't worry about it. They're not going to, they'll be fine. It's 8 months away. But I'm not putting them up. I'm not putting them up for sale right now. Nope. Not with all this, not with all the death threats still coming in. So, you know, people need to start speaking up over there too about stuff. Tools will be all banned over there. Your RSPCA in Scotland is out of control. Next.
Sarah, what are the most important things to teach a new puppy?
So you want to teach bite inhibition, how to go in and out of a crate, how to shut up in a crate, how to not go to the bathroom in a crate, how to go to the bathroom outside, and then you want to start on all your foundational work using the dog's daily food. Next. And also get the dog exposed to as many environmentals as possible. Okay.
Who's dreaming over there?
That's girl.
Oh my God. Hannah, heard Hawaii testimony input was shut down due to the amount of input. Great job, everyone.
Yep. Next.
Yameli, hello, J&J. Do you add a verbal when first starting training a puppy, basic obedience, or do I wait until the tools are introduced? Thanks.
No, tools have nothing to do with it because a lot of people don't train on tools. You don't usually name it until the dog knows it. So, next. Because we're using all foods. So you can do food luring if you want to. You can do a combination of, like, you're usually doing food luring. Yep, next. And then once the dog does it, then you can name it.
One big weirdo. What size prong do you recommend for a 50-pound bulldog?
50-pound bulldog? Bulldog, 50 pounds, 3 millimeter. Next.
I love my pit bull peaches. Hey, all.
Hello.
Next. Mothman, good evening, all.
Hey, Mothman.
Michael, would love to hear your thoughts on Hawaii trying to make e-collars illegal.
Just talked about it. Yep.
Justine, hi, J&J. Just wanted to let you know my confidence is getting better every day. Nice. And today. My kind of corso came to me to let him out. Thank you for the seminar last October that we came to and the videos.
You're welcome.
Melissa posted the link to the GoFundMe.
Awesome.
Gretchen, at one point we're going to have to just grab our dogs and hold them down, I guess. LOL.
No, that's illegal.
That's restraint.
Yep, that's restraint. That was in the bill. That was in the bill. Well, that's not what they meant. They didn't mean that. It's like...
But it's so broad.
It's like you can turn anything into anything. That's what people have got to understand, these Trojan horses that they're using. If this was a don't restrain your dog bill, it would say that at the top in 24-point type. But instead, it doesn't. Banned shock collars was in 24-point type, and everything else was in 8-point type. Next. Yes, I'm fired up about this because people have got to wake up. Oh, that's your agenda. My agenda? No, it should be dog owner's agenda. Anybody with a dog. The last thing we need is more government. You want to boost up your cruelty laws? You already have cruelty laws in place and you don't even enforce those. Plus also, I don't know if anybody's been to Hawaii or not. Who pays for this? Who pays for the enforcement? So let's say, what are they going to do? So you can't crate your dog. That was one of the things. Okay, so somebody gets fined. Who's going to knock on your door and look for crates?
It said in an inhumane way.
In an inhumane way.
So, but that's the thing. It's like, who defines...
What's inhumane?
What's inhumane?
I would love to know what inhumane crating is.
Right. Some people, that would be... a crate, period. They think it's inhumane.
Yeah.
Some people, it's like 5 hours. Some people, it's like 8 hours.
No, there
some
are
people, it's like 1 hour.
There are literally people that feel that crating your dog for any amount of time is inhumane. So there you go.
Right. Now, it's just like, it leaves so much up for interpretation.
Way too much up for interpretation.
Yeah.
Cruel, too. Cruel and inhumane.
It's like you could have a neighbor who just can't stand you and they're calling the police on you. Yep. Like, hey, they crate their dog.
Well, how about this? How about vet offices? Your dog's got to be there for 3 days for surgery recovery. Guess what? It's in a crate for 3 days. Do they get a free pass? Vets seem to get a free pass on cutting dogs open with a knife. Oh, because that's necessary. Well, guess what? using a bonker to stop a leash reactive dog from going after another dog, that's necessary too. So, just saying. Mm. Next.
Cheers from Mexico. Oh my God, I just shut the comments off. Hold on a second. Shoot.
Why'd you do that?
I don't know. I did it accidentally. By accident. Who was it? Oz? Okay, cheers from Mexico City, J&J. Total support.
Hola.
Mothman, this is from last podcast, but you mentioned secret pockets, which reminded me of a time I literally snuck a whole cheeseburger and a can of pop into a movie theater. I wish more coats had them.
So you know what I used to do with my old coats? I used to sew them in.
Sew them in?
Yeah.
Pockets?
Inside pockets. Sure. I used to sew them in. If it was a jacket that I really, really liked, but it didn't have inside pockets, I would make inside pockets. I would use old pairs of jeans.
Thank God.
Yeah, the legs of jeans. I'd make my own inside pockets. Sure, why not? Inside pockets are great.
Next. Alrighty then. Chloe and Luca, I shocked Luca for fence fighting, and he continues to do it. My collar won't go up anymore. I can't do it at the max setting every time. It is constant.
Okay, make sure that you've got proper collar fit. Number one, proper collar fit. Also, I don't know the brand of the collar you're using. They make all different brands with all different models with all different strengths. Number two, don't wait till the dog is fence fighting in drive. Get the dog way before that. Way before that. Okay? It's a thought of fence fighting. Next.
Michelle, hi guys. Going to be a great weekend.
It's going to be a fantastic weekend. With this weekend?
Yeah, she's just saying, hi, guys. It's going to be a great
It's going to be a fantastic weekend.
Yeah.
Do you see that code hookup I put up for Angelo?
I did.
Anybody wants to see the code hookup?
So why, though? Because he had a little stool.
But now he doesn't need the stool. He was stretched on that stool, too.
Gotcha.
So now he's got his own VIP parking spot for his hat and his jacket.
Nice.
Yep. So if anybody wants to see Angelo's new VIP spot, he's got his own little custom code hook there with the letter A next to it for his jacket. Puts his hat on there every morning.
Nobody uses it.
No, well, most people won't.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not convenient. So go to Angelo's Instagram page. That's Angelo Gellman on Instagram. Join his page. He's got great. He puts all his Pokemon tips on there too. He's big. He's almost up to a 6 minute video today, 5 minute video today.
Wow.
He goes on and on and on. Yeah, he did a 45 minute podcast.
He really does talk forever about video games.
He wakes up in the morning? First thing in the morning.
I know.
I'll be literally taking a morning dump and the guy walks in the bathroom and he starts telling me about video games. And I'm like, Angelo, I'm trying to take a shit here. He's like,
he doesn't care.
He's like, but let me tell you about this. And I'm like, okay, Ange. Okay.
Yeah.
He doesn't care.
I know.
And before we go to bed, it's time for bed. So some nights I put him to bed. We're walking upstairs. All the way up, he's telling me about video games. And guess what? In bed, he's talking about video games. He's like, I hope tomorrow I catch the whatever. I love it. I think it's passion. It's passion. Talk about passion. The kid's passionate as fuck.
Yeah.
He really is.
He really doesn't
and
stop.
And today, you want to clear a cool thing today? He's like, Papa, can you help me read this? The instructions on the screen. He's learned this game by not reading. He's gotten to the 8th level on Pokemon, a lot of these things, without being able to read. But today, he wants to start learning how to read all the hints.
Good.
Yeah.
I told him to do that like two weeks ago. Yeah. He's like, I don't need to.
Yeah.
I'm like,
okay.
Wait till you start leveling up, kid.
Yep. Next.
Blessing, I reimagined the bonker. I decreased the length and added thickness. By doing this, I have efficiently created a bonker that has a faster pitch with a firmer contact, all while being easier to carry.
All right.
Introducing bonker 2.0.
We talking about bonkers here? Next.
Doodle doggy, do you think there will be a federal ban on valence tools?
Valence?
Valence's tools.
What the fuck is that? Surveillance?
I don't know.
What the hell is valence?
I don't know.
Violence? Know. Valence? Read my word. Help me out here.
V-A-L-E-N-C-E-S.
I don't know.
Valences,
valences. Educate me. You're talking to somebody that barely made it through high school. Next.
Tanya, I just want to say thank you for all you do for us. Day 2 of coming home to a quiet, calm dog sleeping in his crate.
Nice. Awesome.
Gretchen, I found out about it today, but I would have been more proactive about it if I'd known.
Yep. Yep. So would have I. Yeah. The minute I found out about it, we did a live on it. It was shared almost 250 times, 237 times, 240 times. Mm-hmm. Everybody did. Everybody shared it. Made a huge stink. But it needs to be done now. You need to do it before it gets voted on. Everybody should be calling their lawmakers at the State House now, sharing your stories about the tools, techniques, philosophies that you've used, why you've been successful. And you want them to know, you want to make sure that if anything comes across your desk that has anything about, you know, e-collars, tools, you know, anything like that, boom, we'll be here in force. Mm-hmm. Start doing it now. Next.
Gretchen, I read that. Hannah, I had no clue about it until I saw an article this AM. Very surprised mini educator and Dogtra aren't out there defending their product.
Yep. But there's bigger companies than that. Garmin is huge. Garmin owns, they bought out Tektronics. Garmin is a humongous company because Garmin does a lot of other stuff besides remote collars. But how about the remote collar companies that's all they do? Mm-hmm. They should be out in full force. Next.
Gretchen, my parents are going to let me foster a dog this spring to work on my handling skills. There's 2 deaf dogs available for free right now on Craigslist, but I don't think my parents would let me go for that.
I would. Deaf dogs, from a dog trainer standpoint, deaf dogs definitely build your skill set. Definitely don't get 2 at once. Don't get 2 dogs. Get 1. Just get 1 dog. Next.
Relaxed and too much. Just brought home an 8-week-old husky puppy, and I'm struggling with crate training. I've been researching nonstop and keep getting different information. Help, please.
First of all, it's an 8-week-old puppy. Okay, life's gonna suck for a while, so you're gonna be up a lot. So, number one, I'm not the crate training expert at all, so you're better off talking to somebody that literally does crate training. But there's a lot of mixed messages out there. It's 8 weeks old. It's going to whine. That's a given. Okay? It's going to whimper. That's a given. It's going to bark. That's a given. The biggest thing you want is routine, repetition, and the frequency of letting out and letting in, and put it all on a spreadsheet so you can start logging your time. And then every week that the dog gets older, you start expanding it hopefully by at least an hour longer in the crates. But at 8 weeks old, you're probably going to be getting up at least twice a night. It all depends on where the dog came from and how they, if they let the dog in a crate or they let it just free roam in a pen. Next.
$2 top chat from Gerardo. Does the Swedish government pay for damaged furniture?
No, they don't. Nope. But putting down dogs left and right. Next.
Hannah, I'm a service dog handler. That's a bunch of bull. I literally try to stop a dog eating off of restaurant floors, touching grocery store food.
Yep.
Literally anything gross and unacceptable. A pop on the prong equals done.
Yep, not even that. Or a remote collar. Or any correction. This whole concept that service dogs are trained. I love it how people are saying service dogs are trained with positive only. No, they are not. Now, task training, that's one thing. Public access? No. Also, food fails. How do we know? We use food.
Can I have that tripod that's right over there?
This one? Or do you have the other one?
Oh, it's right here. Just kidding.
Where is it? You have it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Gretchen, honestly, why not let science speak for itself? Nature never breaks her own rules. It's silly to require using positive reinforcement when everyone already uses it, and science will speak for itself as to what works.
Well, be careful about, but let's, how about this? What's, you know what's something that's better than science? Common sense. Mm,
true that.
Let's just use common sense. Let's just do that. So I'm not saying throw science out the window, but use common sense. Also, there has not been any good studies on punishment. Next.
Melissa posted the link to the seminars.
Thank you.
Mothman, wondering what's the best way for 2 dogs to get used to each other. If one is human-dog aggressive, should you focus on obedience and mindset before introducing them at all? And what after that?
Yes. So you want to definitely focus that on that state of mind, obedience definitely, because you want to be able to default to like downstays or place for existence. Migrate, go on walks, get them highly muzzle trained, so they're muzzle trained, and then you want to start correcting any intent. So you want to go for the intent. You want to go for the intent very, very firmly. All right. So remember that once they're fighting, it's too late. I mean, it's not too, I mean, you gotta break it up, but the goal is to get the intent. Next.
Kathy, cool. We'll make them all do downstays and throw the ball first and go from there. Thanks.
Nice.
She Wolf, J&J, I missed you. Sorry I've been away dealing with two new puppies, working on foundation skills, doing great.
The show hasn't been the same without you, so please don't let that happen anymore. Next.
Gretchen, also my dad's mom is moving to a nearby nursing home. She thought she was just visiting. We weren't going to tell her until she was already stuck up here. She found out today and is not happy.
Of course not. Yeah, a lot of, you know, my grandparents are dead now, but my grandmother got kicked out of, like, I don't know, 8 nursing homes, I think.
For smoking.
For smoking. Yeah, so she was getting kicked out. So, but yeah, usually folks are not. I can't wait to go into a really nice nursing home, get my ass wiped, get bathed.
Oh, my God.
You know?
It's like my worst nightmare.
Walking downstairs, getting a nice meal, hanging out, walking around.
It's like telling crude jokes to everybody.
Yeah. I wonder if they have any nursing homes on cruises. You know, you can live on a cruise.
There's people that do that instead of going to nursing
homes. Yeah, there's people that live on cruises. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they don't have...
It's cheaper than going to, like...
But they've got hospitals, but they don't have, like, maybe hardcore. Also, you don't want to be in... For some of your dementia patients, unfortunately, that's probably not the best place for you. Or a sleepwalker. If you're a sleepwalker, cruising isn't a good option. Next.
The thought of a cruise terrifies me a little bit.
Really?
Never been on one.
No.
Never want to.
Oh, you know, when we were over in Europe... And where were we? We were driving from Scotland to England. We stopped in this little village with a canal, and they have a canal with lock systems, and the canal had the long thin boats, and they're about the size of an RV, and you can live in them. People have custom them out. That would be fun to go through the canals on a boat like that, though. Mm-hmm. That would be fun.
Canadian girl, government makes too much money from taxes. That's why they haven't banned cigarettes.
That's one theory right there. Yep.
Cheryl,
But a lot of it's because of the lobbyists. Next.
Cheryl, not only is smoking not good for humans, but secondhand smoke gives cancer to dogs and other pets.
Yes, it does.
Gretchen, me fostering a dog might make it easier for her to move out of here with us. She's got a soft spot for dogs.
What? Then it'll work against you then. Oh, so you don't foster the dog. It'll be easier for her to move out then. Foster a dog, she'll want to stay. Is that what you're saying?
She said me fostering a dog might make it easier for her to move out here.
Move out here. Got it. Next.
Karen, GSD lover. Good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, hi. How are you, Karen?
Kathleen. Hey, J&J.
Hey.
Janine, how can I stop my dog from digging in the backyard? He's two years old lab pit. By the way, you guys are awesome.
Oh, thank you. You know, I was just thinking about...
I knew from the hesitation you weren't going to answer the question.
What's the question?
How do you stop a dog from digging in the yard? He's 2 years old.
Oh, 2 years old? Get yourself a remote collar. Have the collar on and then make sure you got a proper fit. Put on the highest setting. Stand inside your house and wait and look through the window. Wait till your dog starts digging a hole. You can use a tone function on it. Hit tone, which is your no marker. Correct your dog. Hold the button down for 3 seconds. Does it hurt? Yes, it hurts. We have to understand this concept of, like, you should never use any pain or discomfort to train your dog is a lie. It's a marketing ploy. It's a lie. It's an outright blatant lie. Why don't we tell the vets that? My dog just swallowed a sock. Can you please operate on my dog? To save its life, but you can't apply anything painful to the dog. Well, a lot of the stuff we do, since we rehab aggression, we rehab a lot of stuff, we save dogs' lives. So in order to do that, especially with aggression rehab, there has to be certain protocols that are uncomfortable to the dog. It's just the way it is. Well, there's a better way, so-and-so says it. Like, but has so-and-so shown before, during, and after videos? And are they telling the whole truth? No, they're not. Next.
Yameli, hello, Jeff and Joelle. Do you guys think there are certain dog breeds first-time dog owners shouldn't get?
Yes.
Just curious to know your opinion.
Absolutely. A Malinois.
Dutch Shepherd,
Malinois, possibly even a German Shepherd, unless it's a really laid-back dog. I would probably,
Border collies.
Border collies, cattle dogs. I'd be really careful about any of your higher drivey dogs, but I also don't know your skill set. And I don't know what your heart tells you. If you feel that the dog is going to be trained through love and affection, most dogs are going to not do well with you. So, but if you're open to all different training philosophies, which there's only technically reward and punishment, so that makes it really simple, then your life will be easier. But any of your higher drive dogs can be really, really challenging for first-time dog owners. Next.
Trixie, my six-month-old puppy is still mouthy. Always goes after my hand when I try to put collar on her or pet her. How do I stop this?
The bonker. No bonk. If you don't know what a bonker is, look it up. Just Google it. You'll see a photo, a video of me. You'll see a hate video of me. Next.
Gretchen, I can't think of any dog that wouldn't whip around and bite my face for grabbing it because there was no collar or anything else to grab instead.
Yeah, I know. Well, I can. There's plenty of dogs out there that won't. But the point being is, it's like it's really restricting your freedoms. Next.
IP, hi guys. Recently had to move to an apartment with my two large adult dogs. Acceptable to allow them to poop during morning walk or after feeding them?
Yeah.
Or do I establish a command for pooping and walk later?
That's a personal choice. 100% personal choice. Next.
Gretchen. But there's no such thing as inhumane love, despite the over-deposit of love being a huge cause of major problems.
Correct. Next.
Gretchen, you can get away with ignoring the bad laws. It's busybody neighbors who have nothing to do and will peek over the fence and rat you out. 101 reasons I want to live deep in the country.
It's not just neighbors.
True that, man.
It's not just neighbors. It's anybody. It's just anybody. Next.
Raven, I'm looking into fostering. What's the best way to help a new foster dog decompress and be less stressed from being in a new environment?
Structure. Massive amounts of structure. Start the training the minute you grab the leash. Next.
Chloe and Luca is using a dog trough for the fence fighting.
Okay, dog trough, what model is it, though? If it's the 280, the 280 or the ARC, you know, dog trough makes a really strong one. So I don't know if they're still making the 1900 or not. But also, you get, when the dog is in drive, so my Malinois attacks in drive, not running. Okay. Tex on single digits can be corrected for nonsense in here, in my office, say. Say he was going to do something stupid. Say he was going to do something stupid like go over and sniff a trash can. I can probably hit him on 9 out of 100 and he'll go, oh, I'll stay away from the trash can. If we're on a walk and he sees a squirrel, if I hit him on 100, he shakes his head and goes back and doesn't break heel, shakes his head and keeps looking at the squirrel. He's not even in movement. I mean, he's walking, but he's not even in drive. Because he goes into drive. He's a Malinois. So he'll easily blow through 100. So just think about that. That's why what we do is we do something called, we add a punisher at loading. The best example is that video that's been circulated with me with, but if you want to see the bonking video, watch Context is Clarity. It's on my YouTube channel. YouTube channel is called Context Brings Clarity. It's up towards the top. And in that video, it explains the concept of loading. It shows the dog pulls its owner out of the wheelchair. It shows the dog lunging at a dog. Then she resets it. And then the dog is staring. And I even say, like, right there, you can correct. And then we do another pass. It's a seminar, so I'm trying to explain people, giving the dog a couple of, you know, different passes to explain when I'm going to bonk. Owner says no. Always say no first. Dog looks up at the owner, which it's allowed to do. But then you deploy the bonker. I deploy the bonker because you can tell the owner can't really stand. In fact, she's in a wheelchair now permanently. So, but that's when you do it. You do it when the dog is thinking of lunging. We already know the dog lunges. So you know your dog fence fights. So if your dog goes out the backyard and looks at the fence and starts going towards the fence, nail him. Oh my God, that's so mean. No, it's not. Not being able to fix fence fighting is a pain in the ass. Next.
Raven, I'm looking. I already read that. Nelza, hi Jeff. I'm considering doing a Skype with you for my dog that has separation anxiety. Do you think a Skype would be helpful and show improvement?
Yes.
P.S. My dog isn't neutered. He isn't neutered yet. Do you think this is why he may act out? He has a lot of energy and is reactive with separation anxiety.
Nope. Nothing to do with it. The de-sexing of an animal. I'm sure there are dogs out there whose behaviors have changed by de-sexing them. Am I an advocate of spay and neuter? I'm an advocate of choice. Okay? So I'm an advocate of choice. So, you know, I think if you're a responsible dog owner, I mean, accidents can happen, but believe it or not, Kira is 5 years old. She's intact, hasn't gotten pregnant yet. So, you know, and she's around male dogs that are intact. So, it hasn't happened. I'm sure there is a dog out there that it's been de-sexed, that's changed its behavior, but for some weird reason, every dog that you see in our intake videos that are out of control, that I've worked with almost 10,000 dogs, I would say less than 20 are intact. And guess what? They all have got horrific behavior. Next.
Kathleen, my love for inside pockets started this summer at a pack walk. Before we went on the walk, someone asked if we could bring a bonker, and Jeff opened his vest, bonker in the pocket. Yeah, I know. In all the videos, it looks like you have, like, this big lump coming out of you. I'm like, just, like, what are you doing? Or you'll put it in the back so it looks like you have a huge lump in your back. I'm like, it's a fucking bonker.
I'm not trying to hide it. I'm literally just trying to, so I can use two hands. I know,
but it looks terrible for video.
Sorry. I'll balance it on my head.
Maybe. Get a little, like, holster for it.
I will. I'll put it on a little string and hang it from my belt. Right. I will.
That could work.
Yep.
Doodle doggy, sorry, autocorrect, balanced. Oh, when I was like, balanced? Like, what the fuck is balanced?
Oh!
Balanced.
So now what's the
phrase? I have no idea.
Now we don't know what the fucking question was.
I have no idea.
Next.
Blessing. Question, aren't leashes restraints and houses containments?
Yes, they are. So is your car. Your car is a containment. Oh, no, it's not. Yes, it is. It contains the dog from running free. A leash contains and restrains a dog. A leash restrains the dog. It's a restrainment. Of course it is. Next.
Susan, dogs like this. I have really good leash handling skills, or is there something I should have done differently?
One more time. What was the first part?
Dogs like this. Like, is there another piece that I'm missing?
Yeah, we're missing something there. Next.
Gretchen, part of the problem, though, is that people don't know who to contact or email or call.
Yeah, just look it up. Look it up. Look it up. I'm not an expert on politics.
You're not?
No, I just saw this and I decided to make a... I did a live. I did a statement. I'm glad I did. Next.
Melissa posted a link to Skype with you.
Thank you.
Kimba, I know it's not your niche, but do you have any book suggestions for training a dog to help pull you up and picking things up for you, etc.?
No, that goes in the service dog world. So I would look for somebody that works with service dogs and see, or just go on to YouTube. Just go on to YouTube. Everything's on YouTube. Just search on YouTube for those videos. Next.
Nelza, my 10-month-old dog also sleeps during the whole night. Bedtime 9:45, wakes up around 8.
Not wow, holy shit. Damn. It's more sleep than well.
That sounds like a great amount of sleep.
Does it really? You would want to sleep that much.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
No. 10 to 6 would be nice though. Ideally.
10 PM to 6 AM?
Mm-hmm. 8 hours. Or 9 to 5 or 8 to 4.
You'd go to bed at 8? No.
Oh, yeah. That used to be my... Back in corporate world, 8 o'clock.
That's because you went home and couldn't stand talking to your husband.
I know. It was great. I would just run my dogs, train my dogs, go to sleep.
Yeah.
8 to 4. Wake up, go to the gym, go to work. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I got my 8 hours, though. It was nice. I don't get that anymore.
No. No. I'd love to get 6. Next.
Tiffany, common sense isn't very common.
Believe it or not, yes and no. Uncommon sense is just louder. There's a lot of people out there with really common sense. You know, the best example is all of our clients know, they read, they see all these news articles about us too, and they laugh. They think it's funny. Mm-hmm. Like this week, we booked 4 more boarding trains. Mm-hmm. They've all seen the video. They don't care. Why? Because they're struggling with their dogs.
And because, like, I think a lot of it, too, is, like, we are so transparent, and you've always been that way.
Yes.
So it's, like, no one is surprised.
Nobody's surprised.
Like, of course Jeff bonks dogs.
If people are, like, oh, my God, because I've seen some of these groups, you know, they're, like, oh, my God, there's this client, like, everybody knows. The owners are bonking their dogs.
Yeah.
Literally, they come in, we hand them a bonker.
Yeah.
Next. It's just so funny.
And it's, like...
So there are a lot of people out there with common sense. They are, but there's a bunch
rational
of
people.
There's a bunch of people out there that have got nothing better to do but to sit in front of their computer all day long and literally like thousands of emails or thousands of posts, you know, just arguing and hating. Next.
Dolly, my 4-year-old lab and Golden are close and cannot be to be apart. Whining and crying when apart. What exercises can I do to correct this? Is the bonker appropriate?
Yeah. You have to. The way you stop whining is through a proper inhibitor. So you have to correct the dog for whining. Next, a bonker would work.
Greg, I have a female Dutch Shepherd. She has developed resource guarding issues with food. Yep. I've watched your out video.
Excellent.
I don't want to give the food if she is growling. How do I approach this?
You've watched the out video. Do what it says to do in the out video. Next.
But she's already growling before he puts the food down, it sounds like.
Then correct that.
Yeah.
Got it. So my apologies. So correct that. And then still do the out video the way I show it. Yeah. Next.
Gretchen, common sense is so uncommon these days, it's often considered hate speech, LOL.
Actually, not
no.
It. No, you'd be surprised. When I met with the FBI this week about some issues, from safety issues that, you know, where the threats were getting, and there you'd be surprised how what you can say and get away with that is not hate speech. You'd be really surprised. Because I presented them with a bunch of evidence and they're like, man, this is terrible. This is horrific. But there's some stuff that they took interest in. They got copies and addresses and notes. But a lot of that stuff, they're like, you know, this is if you're living in the United States of America, has certain rights which benefit us and they work against us. But there's still certain things you can't do.
Mm-hmm.
Like yelling fire in a crowded theater. It's not your right to do that. Next.
Victoria Makeup. Jeff, you saved my family. Our cat killer now is off leash and relaxed. Thank you so much. We can't wait to see you in Austin.
Oh, Austin's going to be fun. Oh, but that reminds me. If you guys want to go, you know what we're looking for is if anybody's had any, if you're an existing, if any of our videos, my seminar, if you're a client of mine, the podcast, the seminars, any of our advice has literally dramatically saved your dog's life. Possibly saved your dog's life, which is what he does. Saved your relationship, saved your dog's life. Life kept the dog in the home. We're looking to make a bunch of video series on that. So if you're willing to either at least talk about it or write about it, but maybe talk about it, go to our Instagram page, write it. Let me go to the Instagram page right now. And if you go to our Instagram page in the bio of our Instagram page, if you go to the second link down, that's in our bio, how we've helped you, fill that form out. Okay? Fill that form out. If we've helped you, and even in a small way, but the ones that we've helped in a really dramatic way, we want to know because we want to do a little, we're going to start doing a little docu-series because I think it's really, really important that people understand that dogs' lives are being saved. Families are being kept together. Dogs are staying in homes. That narrative needs to be told worldwide, not just for me, but this is for me, but not just for me, but for everybody. Why? Because then your next door neighbor, your cousin, your aunt will go, you know what? Maybe I should try this.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I should try this. So many people have been turned on to tools because they saw a certain video that connected with them.
Mm-hmm.
Literally, one video, same tools, same philosophy goes, you know what? I didn't like that. Another video were like, ooh, I like that.
Mm-hmm.
The exact same thing was done. Mm-hmm. But they just connected with that person a little bit differently.
Yeah.
So we need... We need as many people as possible to do that. So that'd be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Next.
I have closed captioning on YouTube, and it's so bad that when you see the link is in our bio, it's like in our bayou. Like,
why do you turn off closed captioning?
Like in Louisiana, like the bayou.
Really? Right.
Kimbo, living on a cruise would be awesome. LOL, never thought of that.
Yeah, you can do that. They actually offer that. A lot of people retire on a cruise.
Yes, a lot of elderly people.
Yes.
Because you have everything you need.
Yes.
It's cheaper than going to a retirement home.
Not just elderly. There are people that just live on cruises.
Yes, but I'm saying it's cheaper. The monthly cost is cheaper than a retirement home.
Yes, absolutely.
There are elderly people who literally do that.
I know there is.
That's going to be me.
Okay.
That's why I have to stay fit. So I don't need people wiping my ass for me, and I'm just going to go live on a cruise.
I want people just to wipe my ass.
It just sounds so scary. But as long as I stay where it's warm, I don't really give a shit.
So you're not going to do the Alaska cruise?
No.
Do the like Caribbean and stuff? Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, why not? Next.
Mothman. Jeff is going to be living it up in a nursing home. My dad always tells me I need to take him out back before he's going to go to a nursing home.
Next.
David, you're the greatest coach. A month ago, I got a 13-month-old lab. He is very scared of everything, avoids me, and is not food motivated. Need advice.
So he's 13-month-old lab, so he's going through a stage in his life, which could be difficult even if he was the best of dogs, and he's not food motivated. Use the dog's daily food for the training, so don't feed out of a bowl right now. You're not starving your dog. Jeff Gellman did not say starve your dog. He said use the dog's daily food as the motivator. And leash on the dog and start asking the dog to do stuff or make the dog do stuff if you have to. So you got to motivate the dog somehow. If the dog's not self-motivated, you're going to have to use a little bit of compulsion. Compulsion means force. So that's just the way it is. That's the way it is. So we get some dogs here that are just not motivated.
Mm-hmm.
Toy, food, affection, verbal praise, physical touch. They just like, I don't care about any of that stuff.
So,
remote collar pressure, that does motivate them. So I think people have to understand that all dogs are not these happy-go-lucky dogs that walk in here. There's a lot of dogs that are really struggling with just like life, and they need a lot of guidance, a lot of guidance. So massive amounts of structure. Next.
Sabrina, all of a sudden my dog won't come in when called. One with high anxiety sits at the door like she wants to, then runs over and over like a
game. That's a game. It is a game. Your dog is actually playing you. Next.
Rick and Trapper. Hi, J&J. Keep up the good work.
Thanks.
Who's Rick and Trapper?
They're probably a dog-human team. Wait, they call us Rick and Trapper?
Oh, I think that was that from Wednesday Night Show? Was that the
that,
silent people?
That was Laurel and Hardy.
Oh. Who's Rick and Trapper?
I don't know. Thanks.
More people, I don't know.
Maybe that was a side. Maybe it was an insult or a compliment. But thanks for being on the show.
Asia. Maybe it's Rick. And his dog? Like, he's saying it's Rick and Trapper?
Yes. That's probably what I'm thinking.
Oh, he's introducing himself.
Yes.
But, Rick, you've been on here before. Asia.
No, he still wants to say hi.
I know, but he doesn't have to introduce himself, like, because I know who he is.
Well, why not, though?
But that's fine.
Yeah.
Rick and Trapper. Asia, thanks for your advice. Hey, this is Asia who moved to the city with her big dogs.
Ooh.
Thanks for your advice on training my dogs for living in an apartment. I have mom and daughter, German-Australian shepherds.
Nice.
They're doing great at staying in rooms and even make eye contact now. Thanks.
Nice. Awesome.
Cool. Michael, I adopted a 3.5-month-old GSD, and he is now 5.5 months old.
Yes.
The first few weeks having him, he growled a little bit.
Yes.
But seems to have gotten better. Was it something I did, or was it just bonding?
Well, I don't know. I wasn't there. Right? So, but I mean, bonding can make it worse, believe it or not. I mean, repetitive lifestyle, a structured lifestyle, helps build confidence in the dog, a good routine. You know, I mean, did you correct the dog for growling? I don't know. Next.
Anna, 1-year-old Maltese, can now remain in the crate for 4 hours without barking and whining while at work. How to transition her to stay in the house calmly when we're not home.
The dog's crated or not crated?
So she is. Right now, she's crated for 4 hours without barking and whining.
Okay.
But they want to transition her out of the crate to be in the house.
So I don't do that type of training. I'm a huge fan of crating a dog when nobody's home. I'm just a big fan of that. And I know I get flack for that. Oh, my God, you should be able to train that dog to be loose. I just... Anything can happen. A dog, the one day the dog decides to bite through the electrical cable and get shocked and die. Because that's real shocking. That's not remote power shocking. This is like electricity is different. Talk to any electrician about a remote collar. They'll be like, that's not what a shock feels like. All right. So we recommend crating. It's 4 hours in the crate. What's the big deal? Next. So I don't know. So you've got to find a trainer that will help you. That's not actually something we offer or do or recommend. Next.
Asia, I don't have e-collars, but I'm going to make bonks because they are aggressive with other dogs.
Well, keep your dog away from other dogs and muzzle train your dog. And don't let your dog bite any other dogs right now. Next.
Anna, love your philosophy. If only you could teach parents how to train their kids.
Well, I'm still learning how to raise kids. You know what I mean? So, you know, I think the information is out there. There's just so much stuff so between the social media and then the TV that is working against, I think, a lot of people. And then you got parents out there that want to be friends with their kids. It's like, I don't want my kids to hate me, even though I'm sure some of them do. But, you know, but it's not my job to be your friend either. Mm-hmm. My job to raise you and to be a proper adult that can deal with society. You know, with one of my daughters that was struggling with somebody bullying her the other day, I said to her, you know, we talked a lot about it. I explained to her that person that bullies her is struggling. Have some empathy for them. And then I said, just remember, I said, you know, these problems don't go away as you get older. Mm-hmm. So you got to get better. So the problems as you get older actually manifest into either bigger problems or more frequent problems. So you got to get better at dealing with it. It doesn't mean you got to get a thick skin, but you just have to get better at handling it. And that goes through with your personal growth.
Yeah.
But the shit don't go away.
Sure doesn't.
Which door do I go through? Mm. Which one of these doors do I go through?
I'm going to need a lot of hair dye and a lot of Botox.
That's right.
And you're going to have to fund it because it's part of my job.
I'm saving the quarters now. Next. Hair dye, I can get for you cheap at Walgreens.
Yeah, right. Have you met my stylist?
Oh, I got to go. Oh, no.
She ain't cheap.
No.
Oh, go to see her Monday.
Oh, now we got to talk about that. No.
She ain't cheap. Love you, Courtney. I know she watches us.
Hey, Courtney, you do a wonderful job. Thank you so much. Okay?
Nelza, when I use the bark collar on my dog, he turns insane. He goes in circles, barks louder. He's not supposed to do that.
He's not? Well, we see that a lot, though. It's probably set too high. What you need to do is I would use a remote collar first, set the dog up, and learn how to use the remote collar to stop the barking, and then get the bark collar on the dog and make sure it's at the right level. So the dog, it's correcting the dog, causes discomfort, which is fine. I mean, that's how you stop barking. And then the dog is circling around, and it's possible that you've got it set on automatic. Please don't set your bark collars on automatic. And it's possible that he doesn't understand how it goes turns off. Next.
She also said, would you suggest a Skype with you to help with the separation anxiety?
Absolutely.
It's definitely affecting the living situation.
Absolutely, 100%. Next.
Rye, hi, J&J. Glad I caught the show live from the UK.
Oh, thank you, UK. We love you. I actually love the UK. As much hate. It's funny. The most hate we get is from the UK. I love the UK. People are like, when we go over to the UK this summer, people are going to be like, oh my God, how was it? I'm like, it was fantastic. It was fantastic. We meet the most wonderful people wherever we go. Mm-hmm. Literally, wherever we go, we meet the most wonderful people. We got the best fans. We got the best followers.
True story.
It's everything. Yeah, well, can't wait to get to Australia, New Zealand, Singapore. We had to cancel the China one.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Relaxing too much. Thanks, Jeff, for the crate advice. There's so many different tips, suggestions out there for crate training.
I know.
And not a lot of consistency amongst them. How old should he be before I use a correction tool?
Well, believe it or not, a lot of people will be like, oh my God, he says to correct an 8-week-old puppy. Now, say you take the dog out to go to the bathroom and it pees and it poos. Believe it or not, you click and you reward. Go to one spot. Put the dog on a leash, go to one spot. Go out the same door every time. Go to the same spot every time. Let the dog do its business. Click and reward. Make sure the dog fully eliminates its bladder, though. It just doesn't give a quick whiz just to get a food reward. Okay, dogs are smart like that. Bring the dog back in. Put him into the crate. If the dog all of a sudden starts whining, okay. You got to take a double shit. I mean, I've had to take some double shits before, right? You have to have a double poop?
No comment.
Yeah, so that's a yes. You're an athlete. When I used to do triathlons, most runners, if any of my runners are out there, my triathletes are out there, we don't stop. We just, especially for pee.
What?
Oh, yeah.
No.
Pee? Oh, God, yeah.
You just piss yourself?
Of course you do. Absolutely.
I don't know if I've ever heard of such a thing.
Absolutely.
There's got to be some fans who are runners. Please.
No, there are.
Please comment.
Now, I'm not talking about practice. I'm talking about competition. In competition, in a hardcore competition, the Boston.
I thought like your body though, as an athlete, I know every single time I start working out, your body releases some sort of hormone that like blocks your, like the need to go to the bathroom though. Like I'll have to pee, and then as soon as I start working out, it like goes away. Because my body's like, you can't do that right now.
Yeah, but are you doing a 100-mile bike ride?
No.
Okay. So imagine being on a bike for a 100-mile bike ride, and people are like, well, geez, why don't you just stop and piss? Some people don't want to. You lose precious seconds sometimes. You're just fucking pissing your short. You're just pissing whatever you're wearing.
All right.
Talk to any of your military friends that are
I know, like snipers. And shit. Yeah, they have to.
Right. Talk to anybody that does any sort of uniform that takes a long time to get off to get out. Sometimes it's just easier, and you deal with it later.
Okay.
Just letting you know. So if the 8-week-old puppy's whining, okay. Doesn't need to take a double shit. Doesn't need to take a double piss. It's whining and it's playing you. It's okay to throw a bonker at the crate. Quiet bonk. You're going to hear a lot of information that says, oh my gosh, you're using fear, yada, 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 the dog's going to hate the crate, yada, 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 all this bullshit. It's like, you know what? For some funny reason, the dog just learns to shut up and go to sleep in the crate, and everything is fine. Why? Because 95% of the day, 98% of the day, you're doing all reward stuff. But I got to sleep next.
IP, just discovered you guys, binging all past videos, working on my structured prong collar walks with my two pits as well as bark collars.
Nice.
So I can prevent barking before I enter the house from work at 1 a.m.
Great example.
IP, how'd you find us? Welcome.
And also, we've got a new, who'd that video go to, Mackenzie?
What?
Or Maddie? The remote collar heel video.
I edited it. It's going up tomorrow.
Oh, we got a great, the do-it-yourself series. Oh, we got another one going up tomorrow. You edited that one?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
After it took so long.
You got to get rid of all your laughing.
So many stupid bloopers in that one. I'm going to make actually like a blooper reel just from that video alone because it was out of control.
So I would just put the blooper reel up on the Patreon channel.
On the Patreon channel?
Yeah. Sure.
I don't know. It's pretty funny.
Oh, so that one you won't put up on the Patreon channel.
This doesn't, like, bring value, though. It's not valuable. You're not going to learn anything from that except have a really good laugh.
And that's worth going up on the Patreon channel.
Whatever. That was funny.
Next. Did you leave any of them in?
I left one where you're like, you dance.
Oh, you left
that. And starts, like, play bowing with you.
So the one that embarrasses me, you leave in, but the one that you might look slightly foolish, you edit it out.
I wasn't in it. All of a sudden, but you're
laughing.
Yeah.
You're laughing. You didn't leave any of your laughs in?
Right. In that clip, I laughed.
Good.
I'm like, oh my God, he's play bowing with you.
Good.
Tiffany, Jeff needs to just put his bonker on a flexi.
Oh, for it to carry it around?
Drag it around.
Next.
Mothman, now we need a Jeff Gellman DIY crafting series. I need to know how to make inside pockets.
You don't know how to sew?
I can't sew.
You don't know how to sew?
No.
Oh, I can both do hand stitch. I can use a machine, too. You don't know how to use a machine?
What the fuck? No.
You don't know how to thread a needle?
No.
On an electric sewing machine?
No.
Really? No.
My sewing was, Mom, can you fix this hole, please?
Yeah.
And she would do it.
Back when I was in the adult business, So when I was in the adult business, and I was making, we used to sell stripper clothes for the females, but also we had a bunch of guys that were strippers too. Mm. I used to make breakaway pants.
Really?
Yeah. Yep. What I would do is I'd buy military garb, like, you know, camos. And what I would do is I'd cut them down the middle, cut them down the sides on either side. And then I would stitch in very thin Velcro. Or you can also do very light snaps. So snaps that aren't like really, that don't keep it, they're not real strong snaps. Mm. So instead of like a snap, like you would have a snap on your jacket that's really going to keep it closed, you use like a small one that just holds it together. Mm-hmm. So when you whoosh like that, they come right off. Yeah. Yep. I used to make breakaway G-strings. Oh, yeah. Yep. I did it right there in the little store I had. Yep. Downtown. I showed you this location. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Next. Susan, handling skills. Was I doing something wrong?
I don't know.
Susan, I think the first part of your thing keeps getting cut off because it might be too long.
It might be too long.
We keep only getting the second half of the question.
Yeah.
Julia's gallery, dropping by to say hello to both of you.
Oh, thanks.
Morgan, I love watching the show when I'm out with my dogs. I don't understand why everyone we pass whistles at them. Like, do them really think my dogs give a crap about them at all?
They do, though. Next.
Yeah. Teresa, how do you calm a high-strung pit? He's driving us nuts. Thanks.
Watch my videos. Watch what we do. Watch the work we do. Guys, all the secrets are there. All of the secrets are there. Start out with massive amounts of structure. Teach duration. Learn how to get rid of arousal with a bonker. This is the thing. Here's a great example. The German Shepherd that just came in with... sitting on the couch with a woman, mm-hmm. lunging.
Schultz.
A lot of people were like, ooh, I got to pay attention to this one. Good. I'm so glad you did that. I'm glad you're paying attention.
He got a lot of traction, that Schultz.
But guess what, though? We're going to do the same thing with that dog that we do with all the other lunging dogs. Mm-hmm. It's the same. Guys, it's the same. It's almost the same recipe. Oh, you have a one-size-fits-all training. Well, on stopping lunging, yeah. Mm-hmm. Stopping barking? Yeah. Stopping whining? Yeah. Pretty much.
We have two, like...
There's variations, slight variations, but, like, that dog stopped lunging in seconds. Next.
We have two shepherds, and they both came in the same day.
Right.
They both struggle with leash reactivity.
Yeah.
But, like, they're the most social dogs ever.
Yeah.
Like, they're so social.
Yeah.
But it just shows it's, like, it's still dangerous, though. Like,
yes.
They drag their owners around. Yeah. Everyone on the street's afraid of them.
Hey, if you drag your owner around to say hi to a dog or to fight a dog, you still got your ass to hand it to you.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Morgan, I already read that. Teresa, how do you call... I already read that, too. Jeez. She-Wolf, congratulations on your new docuseries.
Well, it's not quite a docuseries.
I was like, what the heck's our docuseries?
No, I'm just looking for videos to start featuring success stories. That's all. I'm just trying to do more educational stuff for people. That's all.
Next. I think you might have said docuseries.
Oh, sorry. Though. I didn't mean that.
Kathleen, I love that idea. I filled out that form a couple weeks ago, and I only wish I could have put into words what you all have done for me. Kathleen, yours made me cry, and I messaged you about it because you did make me cry.
Yeah, so Kathleen, hey, do redo it. Put it again if you want to redo it. Next.
Karen, a cruise ship is like a floating prison. Billy Connolly. I agree. See, that's how I feel like it would get very, like...
But they stop. They make stops.
Yeah.
And hey, none's keeping you from fucking jumping overboard. So, you know...
The ocean.
And you swim in it. Grab your little yellow life jacket. And die. No, you won't die. You'll float for a while.
Dive.
You thought you had wrinkles then.
Dive, you'll have dehydration, starvation,
yeah, you bring some sunburn. Water with you. You'll bring some water with you.
Sounds miserable.
Yeah, put some SPF 50 on your whatever it's called.
Melissa posted the link to the WooFoo form.
Oh, thank you.
Deb, if you live on a cruise and you need hospitalization, they will boot you off the ship and you are on your own to get back to the ship. Been there. Bad experience. LOL.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God. Medical on some islands is scary. Well,
but hold on. But don't they have helicopters on these ships? They can get out. Don't most cruise ships have a helicopter landing pad?
I've never been on one. I don't know.
Or they could definitely, but how about this? You prepare for it. Have really good insurance. So when I used to do some hardcore backpacking, did I ever take out, oh no, when I went to Europe to backpack through, we did Germany, we Denmark, we took a train to, but we did Germany, Switzerland, some of the Swiss Alps. I contacted my insurance agent. I took out a separate policy that included airplane, helicopter ambulance. Yep, and rescue. Yeah, I took out like a search and rescue policy.
You know, that's like the scariest thing to me is because I do hike a lot alone. It's like, what the hell would I do if I just like rolled my ankle right now?
But that's the places you go to. I told you that one time that I was stuck on the top of a mountain with a fractured foot.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep.
I had a place. But I'm saying though, I used to hike like in Massachusetts and stuff. Like, alone.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
What the hell would I do?
You deal with it. Someone.
It's like my biggest fear.
But you hike around people. There's always. But you have a cell phone. You fucking call 911.
I guess. Who's going to come rescue you?
Rescuers.
Really?
A first responder.
They come hike up the mountain to get you?
Well, when I fractured my foot on the top of this mountain. So going down, going downhill, the downstep, massive pain.
Oh, God.
Massive pain. Like, we're talking massive pain.
I know the pain.
So what did I do? I backpacked walking down the mountain backwards. I walked down this whole mountain walking backwards because then there was no pain.
Your feet must have been.
I got to the bottom of the mountain and I call 911 and I said, hey, I'm injured and I'm stuck. Is there a bus service that like I can get to the closest town? I was like, this goes back way before iPhones. So the cell phones were like, you couldn't do GPS on your cell phone or anything like that. So you couldn't like look up on the internet on your phone at all. So, and they're like, no, there's no bus on that route at all. I'm like, do you guys have like taxis around here? Nope, no taxis around here. I'm like, well, what do I do? They go, we'll send an ambulance out here, out there. I said, I don't need an ambulance. If you give me transportation, I'll go to the hospital myself. I mean, I would hitchhike back then too, with my kids. But the girls and I have got so many hitchhiking stories.
Don't go on another tangent. Just finish this one.
So anyway, so an ambulance. So they said, I said, "Fuck, are you serious? You're gonna send a goddamn ambulance out for me?"
Just send a cruiser.
So they send an ambulance out for me. Two guys get out. One in very good shape. One in not such good shape. I asked me what happened. I told him what happened. He goes, thank you so much for walking down. He goes, last week, we had to get somebody off the mountain. And I'm like, I looked at him. I'm like, you climbed up that thing? He goes, this guy worked up a sweat getting from the ambulance 20 feet over to me. I just can't imagine him walking up the fucking mountain. I just can't. So he's like, he puts me in the ambulance. So I get in the ambulance and I'm like, don't put the lights on. Like, guys.
The sirens.
Yeah, I'm like, blazing. I'm like, it's really no big deal. I got a fractured foot.
Get out of work.
it's like, it took me 4.5 hours to get down this fucking mountain. I said, I can wait.
This is the longest story ever.
I can wait the half hour to get to the hospital. So I get to the hospital.
It's still going.
I get to the hospital. And I get in there. Very efficient. Oh, my God. Best hospital experience I've ever had. So I get there. And they're like, okay, you have to take off your boots. And I'm like, I've been already a week. No bathing.
Ew.
No bathing.
Ew.
And I'm like, I take off my boots. And it's been raining. And I've been, when it rains for 5-6 days in a row and you're always walking through mud.
Ew.
It is disgusting. Anyway, so I'm like, I'm really sorry, guys. But I took off my boot and it like fucking, it was like swamp ass.
All the doctors pass out. We need emergency care now.
So they take me to the x-ray room and they're like, okay. So you got a fracture on your foot. I said, yeah, I know. And they're like, I said, okay, so what are we going to do? I said, what, just take a couple days rest? I can go back up on the trail? And they're like, no, you're done. I said, what do you mean I'm done? There's nothing you can do? They said, no, you're done. If you keep walking on this fucking foot, you're going to be like highly injured. And I had to end my trip.
Alrighty.
So.
Now you know.
That's it.
How the fuck did we just get on that tangent?
I don't know.
Cruise ship hospitals?
Yeah. Yes. But anyway, so when I went to Europe, I took out a special insurance policy that included an air ambulance.
Good to know.
Get me back to the United States, actually. Yep. Next.
Sasha, how do I stop my dog eating the cat food? Is it behavior? I walk her to train her.
Yeah. Walking won't help anything. Behavior. Set the dog up. Let the dog get next to the, close to the cat food. Say no. Bonk the dog. No. Give the dog a correction. Next.
Yameli, hello guys. My puppy nips, growls, and is a bit skirmish when I hold her. Should I bonk? Thank you.
One more time. Nips and bonks. Nips and what?
Nips, growls, and is a bit skirmish.
Which is probably
squeamish.
Right. Skirmish. Skirmish around. Like, yeah, right.
When
yeah.
I hold her.
Yeah, the act of skirming.
Pressure release.
Well, what kind of holding are you doing?
And what? How old is the puppy?
Yeah, how old is the dog? I need a little bit more information on that. So, but yeah, you could bonk for that. But. Let me get me some more information next.
Karen, there's...
The Noble Dogs. Did you see the top chat from the Noble Dogs?
No, it didn't come through.
What's the Noble Dogs 499 top chat? How come you didn't get it? You're right, you didn't get it. What's the best way to fight e-collar legislation? I'm planning on talking with some of my elected officials. I think it's important that they understand that it's the remote collar, it's a lifesaver, number one. It's a lifesaver. I get it. They're probably getting the message that it's abusive. See, that's the thing is, like, all these groups are going, they're throwing the abuse card out there. They're just saying, it's abusive. It's like millions of people in the United States use remote collars. Like, even in the UK, where they can't stand them, 300,000 people use remote collars. Mm-hmm. So it's like, so what you want to do is you want to talk to them about, like, you know, success stories. Maybe get some videos from your fans of their success stories with the remote collar. Do something like that. Maybe do a podcast and announce it. And maybe that you can use it for something like that. And then I think what you can do is just talk to them more about, what the realities of it are. Next.
Karen, there's no better feeling in the world for me when I get out and my dog is in the crate. When I go out.
Yes, it's a great feeling. Next.
Nelza, I'm also in Toronto. I wanted help with separation anxiety, and literally everyone said that they don't work with that case.
What? That's like the bread and butter of a dog trainer, separation anxiety. We can do a freaking Skype. I'm also doing a seminar in Toronto and one in Buffalo, but do a Skype. I can fix that easily. Next.
Fernanda, hello you guys from the province in Canada that Joelle cannot pronounce. Lots of love and good vibes, Friday.
What's that?
Saskatchewan? Saskatchewan?
That's good phonetic spelling.
Saskatchewan?
Yep, Saskatchewan.
Saskatchewan?
Yes.
Is that it?
Yes. I believe it's an Indian name.
I like Saskatchewan.
Do that too.
Sassy.
That sounds like a Cajun food dish.
Saskatchewan.
That's right.
What is it? Saskatchewan?
What are you doing tonight?
Saskatchewan.
A little bit of Saskatchewan.
Saskatchewan.
What's in that canister? What's in that little canister? Oh, it's Saskatchewan. What's in that bottle over there on the shelf? Oh, that's Saskatchewan sauce.
Saskatchewan.
Yes, Saskatchewan.
Saskatchewan.
Next.
Jason. Well said, Jeff. With my two kids, I've always argued with my wife about squashing little problems. Little problems turn into big problems. Reality check, please.
Yep.
Ooh, good point, Jason.
Yep. Next.
Same with dogs. Michael, have you ever worked with an Anatolian Shepherd?
Yes, many. Well, many. Less than 10. Next.
Teresa, I do believe in crate training. I use it after walks. He's hyper after coming home. I want to restart basic training with my 2-year-old pit boxer mix. How do I restart with him?
Start with the basics. Literally, start with the basics. Start with your foundational leadership skills in and out of a crate with permission, thresholds. Do all your leash handling skills. Next.
IP, how often, duration, every day, do you recommend structured walks to help reduce anxiety before leaving the house?
Exercise in general is good. Duration's going to be your best friend. And then also correcting. There are things you can correct. You actually can correct. I can't correct anxiety, but the physical... Any sort of physical reaction to the anxiety we can correct. Next.
PH, that's right. Just keep running and piss your pants.
Yeah. If you want to win, if you want a place.
I don't think I could run with that.
Yeah, you can.
That would slow me down.
No.
Absolutely, 100%.
Once it starts, it's so easy.
But you, like,
once you start peeing,
hygiene freak. I wouldn't be able to perform my best.
Then you go to the side, find a bush, go in between two cars, drop trowel,
push it
squat
out with
down,
full force.
And go, and then get back on the run. They do that as well.
Yep.
They do that as well. Next.
It's like a stream.
Yep.
Doodle doggy. My mom has ran multiple marathons. Boston Marathon. I'll have to ask her when I see her.
Yeah, ask her. Ask her how many people have crapped their pants. ask her how many people.
I cannot.
Ask how many people cross the finish line with shit running down their legs. Ask.
Michael, can a bonker be replaced with an electric collar?
Two different. They can be. There's two totally different purposes. So that's not. It's like apples to oranges. Next.
Mothman, just imagining Jeff in a triathlon and a diaper. Thanks, Jeff.
No, no diapers for me.
No diapers. Just shit right through his pants.
Nope.
Dog.
Actually, it would go right through. Well, it's really bad,
like,
if you're on the
shorts.
If you're on the bike though, because you got the bike, you got the chamois right there with your crotches. That's not good. Next.
Sounds pretty bad.
Yep.
Dog hates. Hi, argument between me and my partner. Does the dog need water in a crate for 4 to 5 hours? I say no, but he worries.
So your partner's a worrywart. No, you don't need it. Unless, I mean, if you're in 120 degree temperature, the dog's like no, but your dog doesn't need it. No.
Relaxing too much. Thanks again. Very helpful advice. He had double pooped several times already. Can I set up a Skype with you also?
Absolutely. Yeah, guys, of course. So I give out so much free content, but I need to make a living. So you always can set up a Skype, which you pay for. But can I help everybody out a little bit out here? If you join our Patreon channel, there's a level of Skype, a level of membership that your Skypes are greatly reduced in price. So go to patreon.com/solidcaninetraining. It says it right there. And compare what our website says for Skypes and what the Patreon channel says for Skypes. Same information. I mean, I'll give you the sales. I'll help you with just as much love and passion. And I don't make crude jokes. And I'm not going to talk to you about shitting your fucking pants. We're not going to talk about getting off of a cruise and climbing down a mountain. We're going to stick to business. Next.
Gerardo, how do you keep an off-leash heel?
Start off with an on-leash heel. And then start with a leash drag with an off-leash heel. And then with an off-leash heel, practice directional changes. Do little figure eights. Get your dog to make sure your dog understands the remote collar really, really well. Next.
Gretchen, sewing is so basic. I hated it, though, in 4-H. Grew a fear of needles after I saw some horrible injuries with sewing machines. Never craved going back to it.
Yep. There are people that stitch their hands to what they're sewing.
No.
Of course. Yes. Man, when you sew, you gotta also know basic repairs of the machine too. You gotta learn how to troubleshoot. Next.
Barista boy.
Gotta change a bobbin. I was changing up bobbins blindfolded.
Jeff, where do you get those shirts? They look durable for like hiking.
No, I wouldn't use this for hiking because it's not a quick dry. Where's this shirt come from?
It's like a thermal.
Yeah.
That's probably like, I don't know.
Amazon
one of those
or something.
Outdoor stores.
Yeah.
Cabela's
or
Best
something.
Pro or
yeah.
something.
Yeah. All my hiking stuff was all quick dry stuff because I wore it continuously. Next.
Susan. Again, it's cut off, Susan. We're only getting the second half. So whatever. Your first half is too long. So try breaking it up into like 2 or 3 seconds.
Yes. For some reason, Susan, what happens is it literally disappears.
Yeah. It's just not here. Kathleen. Haha. You did message me. Made my day.
Awesome.
Deb. An international water jurisdiction is the next scheduled port of call. Yes, ships have helipads, but they're still going to take you to the island hospital. And we learned just how money-hungry they are when dealing with rich Americans. Yeah, I have stories for you. Another cruise, a friend in our group passed away. Learned a lot about that as well.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit.
Jeez.
This makes me really not want to go on a cruise.
Well, just throw the person overboard.
That is not funny.
Was it a joke? Too soon?
Yes.
It was that. I'm sorry, Deb. Sorry about that. If that was maybe how about if in his or her will it said they wanted to be buried at sea? It's actually probably illegal to throw somebody overboard.
Probably.
But people fall overboard, though.
That just makes me not want to go on a cruise, though. That sounds horrific.
Okay. People die all the time, everywhere.
Yep. I still hate airplanes, though. I've been on how many flights now? Probably well okay. over.
Okay. What's worse? Dying on a cruise or dying in the middle of sex with the woman's doing a reverse cowboy on you?
Wait, who am I in this ordeal?
You stay alive.
That's
So you stay alive. So die. How would you like to do the reverse cowboy and the person underneath you dies?
That is tragic.
Would you be charged with a crime?
Would you be? You have to call the police. Like, this person died.
Technically, you might have killed them.
Right, you murdered them.
It wouldn't be murder. It's not murder, though. Well, it would be murder.
It's your word against a dead person.
It's not murder, though. It would be, what's that, unintentional murder? So it's not like...
That, I think, is worse.
No, it's not. Oh, no. Planned murder is worse.
No, I'm saying between dying on a cruise ship or that's worse.
Why? Because if you went to...
Some traumatizing shit. Shut up. Shut up.
You couldn't have waited 30 more seconds?
Fuck. PH, awesome show as always. Thanks.
Yeah, that comment was before this conversation, though.
Yeah. Gretchen, Jeff, is January still open for internships?
I think it is, Gretch.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Greg, earlier you said correct the growling first, then the resource guarding food. Should I use e-collar or bonker first?
E-collar, next.
Kibu, Saskatoon is a berry. Saskatchewan is the province.
See that? So Saskatoon juice. There is such a thing.
Interesting. Lynn, hi J&J. Just filled out the WooFoo survey. Keep on doing what you're doing. You are both so appreciated.
I'm trying hard, man. Next.
Gretchen, old-fashioned clothing sewing where they had to fit the outfit right onto the person. They'd sometimes sew it right into the skin. No. Nope. Give me the potato sacks. Susan, had a client dog. I was prong collar introducing with the prong collar dance. Ah, okay. I have good leash handling skills.
Okay.
Did I do something wrong? Has this happened to you?
What happened?
I don't know. We keep missing that part.
Okay,
I'm assuming the dog probably, like...
So say the dog freaked out. Say the dog redirected on you. Say the dog totally shut down. It could have just been an objection from the dog, if those are any of those things that have happened. We have seen dogs, not just with a prong collar. We have seen dogs with... They've never had a collar on them. You put a collar on the dog, and it totally freaks out. It freezes. It's never felt anything on its neck. It's always worn a harness. Next.
Karen, the messages are 200 characters and there's a counter. That's on my computer, but might be different on smartphones.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not asking questions.
I don't know why it won't keep coming through.
I'm not asking.
Oh, okay. He flailed for 30 minutes.
Oh, 30.
An alligator rolled.
Okay, that's called an objection. That's literally an objection. Next.
It's called manslaughter.
What?
If someone dies.
A reverse cowboy?
I guess so.
So Michelle, who knew that? Michelle?
That is Michelle and Michelle. There's two.
Figures Michelle Anderson knows the answer to that.
So manslaughter is unintentional killing
right.
of someone?
Yes.
Do you still get charged with a crime?
Of course, you get charged with manslaughter.
Even if you're just like, what if they die of natural causes?
Okay.
In that scenario.
Okay. If you're in a car accident and you hit somebody... And unfortunately, they pass. You'll probably be charged with manslaughter, not murder.
Yeah, agreed. That, like...
Okay, so, reverse cowboy on somebody. You didn't intend for them to die either.
That's like, what if they die of natural causes, though? What if they just had a heart attack?
They probably did have a heart attack! That's probably why they died!
What the fuck? And you could be charged with manslaughter?
I imagine you could be. I'm sure there's a case. Somebody look it up. Has anybody ever been charged for a crime as the sex partner during sex of the person that died? I'm sure it's happened.
Oh, my God. I'm going to be up all night Googling this shit.
Yep.
That's scary.
Yep.
Rick said they put them in the cooler till the next stop. Aye, 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 you guys.
Oh, my God. Well, better than that than leaving them in the room. Fucking housekeeping. Housekeeping don't get paid enough for that.
God. But. Carmen, our freaking fans are out of control. I have a 2-year-old ACD. I had him since a pup. Found you 1.5 years ago. Never chatted live. Finally wanted to say hi. Thank you. Learned so much from you. Now have an off-leash, e-collar, balance, adventure buddy. Thank you for teaching us.
Oh, you're welcome, Carmen.
That's awesome.
Carmen, thank you so much. If you feel like filling out that woofoo form, that'd be great.
Angela said, cruising to the Cozumel next Thursday.
Nice.
Gretchen, I've had a fear of stepping on needles for the next 10 years of my life.
Right.
Doggy Doodle, death by ejaculation.
There you go. See that?
Michelle.
Well, that's assuming there was ejaculation.
Michelle, you could claim self-defense during a reverse cowboy. Just saying.
Michelle is an expert on sex position defense.
She said, no way, guys. That's not manslaughter. Maybe rough sex, but a heart attack? No. Gretchen said her ears are bleeding. Tiffany, only BDSM gone wrong. And no, there are morgues on cruise ships.
Right. But hold on. It's not BDSM. Well, actually, I shouldn't say that. Technically, everyone's got a fetish. Theoretically.
It's 9:29.
So I shouldn't go on a rant.
Probably not.
Okay, keep going.
That's it right now.
Oh.
Look at that. We made it through all of them, even with all this fucking wacky new shit.
Yeah. The wacky new shit?
The wacky new shit. We went on a lot of... We went really off-key on this one.
Did we?
Yeah.
Well, that's why I changed the title of the show from What Would Jeff Do Q&A and More.
Oh, you did?
Oh, God, yeah. A long time ago. Yeah. Yeah, I changed it. Yeah.
Joelle, you sound so cute saying A-A-A, Jeff's turn. A-A-A?
I should say A-A-A?
It's not gonna be A-A-A? Michelle said, damn, I wanted that rant.
Michelle.
Tiffany said, same. I was looking forward to that.
No time for the rant. No.
Nope.
All right, no sex rants tonight.
Someone has to censor him.
Okay. All right, guys. Madly in love with you. I appreciate all of you. If any of you have had any life-changing, life-saving, meaning through our content, through a seminar, through a podcast, through a Skype, through this show, we've dramatically changed the life of you and your dog, possibly saved your relationship, your marriage, which I know we've done with many people, okay? Kept your dog alive. Go to our, there's a form that's on our Instagram handle. Go to that. Fill it out. It's a woofoo form. Fill it out. And somebody might contact you and want to hear that story. Okay? So, madly in love with all of you. Take care.
Good night.
And we'll be back on Monday night. Next.
Next.
Week.